You don't want to talk about it? Can we talk about the fact that my grades have dropped? How selfish can you be?
What happened to sticking together?
I guess I'm just not feeling it anymore. Sorry.
You know what? This is too much.
Hey. Welcome to my channel or welcome back to my channel. And today we're going to dive into a movie that I completely forgot even existed. And that movie is called Bratz, the movie. Now you might be thinking, Bratz, I've definitely heard that name before. But if you're not familiar, let me fill you in. Bratz is a popular line of fashion dolls that was launched back in 2001. They became an instant hit thanks to their trendy outfits, exaggerated facial features, and diverse skin tones. In fact, they were so popular that they even rivaled Barbie. And if you know about Barbie, you know that's a big deal. With their massive success, the Bratz doll inspired their own games, TV shows, and yes, movies. Which brings me back to the main topic of today's video. So without further ado, what is Bratz the movie all about? Bratz follow the lives of a group of four teenagers named Yasmin, Sasha, Chloe, and Jade, who have been friends since childhood. The only thing you have to know about them throughout this whole film is that Yasmin has Mexican heritage, which is portrayed in the film.
Buenos dias!
She has a quirky younger brother who sims on the main antagonist, who I'm going to talk about later on. She also loves to sing, but she struggles with stage fright, and she's interested in journalism, which the film never portrays. Sasha, on the other hand, is passionate about music and dance, particularly hip-hop. She also joins the cheerleading squad and is also revealed that her parents are divorced. Chloe, on the other hand, is the clumsy one in the group, and you see this a lot in the film. Despite her clumsiness, she has a strong love for fashion and is passionate about sports, especially soccer, which I will refer to as football. Chloe is so skilled at football that she even performed a front flip while doing a throw-in, which is quite impressive. But at the same time, I don't know if it's legal in football. Oh, it is. And lastly, there's Jade. Jade has strict parents who don't allow her to express herself through clothing. Despite this, she loves fashion so much that she has a secret wardrobe. I repeat, a secret room, I mean, in her bedroom. I have so many questions like, how does she manage to create it, or how her parents doesn't know about it? She's also very smart and is interested in science, and that's basically the only thing you have to know about them. Jumping back to the story, the Bratz are now entering high school, but before that, they obviously had to get ready while jamming to some 2000 music. When they arrive, they exchange some positive advice with each other. As they were about to enter the building, they stopped immediately because Jade needed to get changed. Now you're probably thinking, what do you mean she needs to change? She's already dressed. Well, Jade is super into fashion, and one outfit just wasn't enough. So, here's the thing, she could have waited and changed inside a bathroom, but no. Jade decided to get changed in public, and somehow, no one noticed, even though she was literally tossing clothes into the air. After this, like every high school movie, there has to be a queen bee. In this case, it's Meredith, who of course has a dog that I cannot pronounce, in her designer bag. Meredith is the daughter of the principal and has two sidekicks, Quinn and Avery. She also hangs out with her cousin Cameron, who for some reason is always with her. The only thing you have to know about her is that she's rich, her dad owns the school, and she's obsessed with maintaining the social hierarchy. People actually line up just so she can assign them to the social group. And her dad, he lets her make his decisions for him, even though she's embarrassed to be seen with him.
Okay, Daddy. I've told you this more than 50 times. You may not speak to me during school hours.
You know what? You know what? I have no comeback.
Now, the music changes and the Bratz enter the school in style. They're so stylish that everyone gives them way and stares as if they've never seen four well-dressed teenagers before. Meredith immediately sees them as a threat to her dominance and starts plotting to sabotage their friendship. Soon enough, the girls drift apart. Chloe joins the football team, Sasha joins the cheerleading squad, Jade joins the chemistry and fashion clubs. Yasmin, however, hasn't joined any clubs yet, but she does bump into someone. This is where we meet Dylan, who's interested in music. The only thing you have to know about him is that he loves to DJ and is deaf, though Yasmin has some doubts about that.
I'm deaf.
You don't sound deaf.
Well, you don't look ignorant, but I guess you can't judge a book, right?
What did he say?
Now it's lunchtime, and apparently you can't just sit anywhere. You need to be assigned to a table. The girls ignore Meredith's rule and sit together, but soon go their separate ways, leaving Yasmin to sit all alone. From there, their friendship starts to crumble bit by bit. 2 years later, now there's a time skip for some reason. They're completely forgotten about each other's announce, and for the first time in 2 years, Yasmin and Jade finally speak to each other. Cut to another lunch scene where Meredith tells her dog to stop Cameron from talking to Chloe. The dog listens, bites Chloe's trousers, and causes her to drop her food. This starts a chain reaction. Chloe's food spills on Jade, Jade's food spills on Sasha, and Sasha's reaction causes Yasmin to drop her food. The entire school ends up in a chaotic food fight, and as a result of this, the school's statue breaks. The thing is, all of this could have been avoided.
You. Detention.
This doesn't even look like detention, more like a photo shoot. Why is Chloe standing there as if she's posing? If this was an album cover, it would be fire. They were arguing, and while this was happening, Chloe is still posing. Then suddenly they made up, and next thing you know, they're hanging out like nothing happened. After rewatching this movie, one thing I didn't like about this film is the script. I understand the actors were trying their best, but the dialogue feels stale and too forced.
I started writing some music, and yes, it's sounding pretty good, and no, you can't hear it.
Stage fright?
Yeah.
While hanging out, they saw Dylan, and both Dylan and Yasmin started developing feelings for each other. Honestly, the only thing I really enjoyed about this film was the music, especially this part. Sasha, Jade, Yasmin, and Chloe decided to hang out together at school, and people were literally staring at them. Why, you ask? Because they were friends. Sasha, Chloe, and Jade's friends from their respective clubs invited them to hang out, but they all said no. Their reactions were intense, and the background characters were just staring, specifically those two. Another problem I have with this movie is how every cliche thing you hear about high school is just thrown in this film. Then it's lunchtime again, and guess what? Everyone is staring at them. Even people who don't even talk to them are staring. Like, what business does Sasha, Yasmin, Chloe, and Jade have with these random students? Even the security guards are staring. As I said before, this movie is dramatic for no reason. Oh, I forgot to mention, this is Dexter. All you need to know about him is that he's a science club member, he can fight, I think, and he has a crush on Jade. On a side note, the number of times Yasmin bites her lips in this film should be studied. After an incident, Yasmin's brother, who simps over Meredith, shares a video of Yasmin singing to her. Why, you ask? Apparently this video is supposed to be embarrassing for some reason, and Meredith plans to use it to expose Yasmin. It's time for shopping, and everyone is enjoying themselves except Chloe. The reason? She couldn't afford any clothes to wear for Meredith's birthday party. Her reaction to the situation was heartbreaking, in quotes.
But Sasha, I have nothing to wear.
Sasha, noticing her friend's distress, offers Chloe one of her gift certificates, because she has two, by the way, and Chloe's mood instantly lifts. A shopping montage follows, filled with fun and laughter as the girls try on outfits. Yasmin showcases her singing skills, captivating Dylan with her voice.
Yeah, like beyond amazing.
Seriously? Thanks.
Late in the film, when Chloe returns home, she finds her mom struggling with preparation for Meredith's birthday party. Not realizing the party's for Meredith, Chloe calls her friends for help. Without hesitation, they all respond with, "I'm there." Then Chloe's mom casually mentions that the party's for Meredith, and the girls' reactions were priceless. They reluctantly agree to continue helping, but Jay decides to switch up the costume for the event. The reason? She wants to make a statement, although why does she have a stapler randomly and Sasha has something else remains a mystery. They joke about it and continue with their day. Despite the confusion, the girls reveal their new costume, and surprisingly, everyone loves them. During the party, Meredith invites Yasmin on stage to sing. Yasmin steps up but doesn't sing. Instead, she gets overwhelmed and runs away. Meredith seizes the moment, playing an embarrassing video of Yasmin that her brother gave her. The crowd laughs, of course, and Meredith gets the reaction that she wanted. Yasmin is humiliated. Just as the situation spirals, Yasmin's soon-to-be boyfriend diverts attention by inviting everyone to dance without moving his lips. Miraculously, it works and everyone forgets about the video. And in a dramatic moment, someone says the title of the film without the movie part. The girls are having lunch again, and it seems like all they do is eat and attend clubs at school. The cheerleading squad leader gives Sasha an ultimatum: either keep hanging out with them and ditch her friends, or get kicked off the team.
If you don't want to hang out with us, then maybe you don't have the right kind of school spirit for the job.
So you're saying if I'm not a part of your clique, I'm off the squad? Think about it.
Makes sense, don't it? Makes sense, don't it? Makes sense, don't it?
Jade faces the same decision. As for Chloe, it's unclear what her situation is. Determined to help Chloe, the girls decided to enter the talent show to win the scholarship money for her.
Well, if it isn't the Bratz!
Here I come.
A montage shows them preparing for the performance, with most of the school joining in, mainly because everyone dislikes Meredith.
You guys like totally love me?
Meredith finds out about their plan and somehow contacts Yasmin. She blackmails her, and that's basically the only thing you have to know about in the scene. Yasmin decides to drop out from the talent show and blames her friends for everything.
What?
I'm sorry. It's just, you guys kind of pulled me into it, and I never really wanted to do it anyway.
No, it's not. It's just not my thing. It's kind of stupid.
The girls exchange dramatic words, and Yasmin is clearly upset. Though, it's a little hard to tell, is it? Yippee! Finally, it's the talent show day. Everyone, including Meredith, performs their act. The Bratz made a grand dramatic entrance because, of course, they're the main characters. Meredith tries to expose Yasmin, Sasha, Jade, and Chloe, but in hindsight, it wasn't a big deal. Now looking at the scene, it feels unnecessary. The Bratz perform their song, and surprisingly, the song isn't that bad. Meredith wins the talent show, which comes to no surprise, but the Bratz win the scholarship and the crowd goes wild. The movie ends with the Bratz becoming superstars. Although it's unclear how, the song wasn't particularly great and they were just lip-syncing the whole time. But for them, it was a masterpiece. That, ladies and gentlemen, was Bratz the movie.